50 to 80% of our individuals with autism experience sleep problems. And in comparison to typically developing individuals, they're around 25%. So you're looking at 2 to 3 times more prevalent in the autism population.
Right now, it's showtime.
So the last intervention that I'll go through is the faded bedtime intervention. So this involves delaying the child's bedtime until they're ready to go to sleep. You would start by identifying what the ideal bedtime is. So you want your kid to be ready to sleep at 9 o'clock at night. Great, that's our identified ideal bedtime. You take a look at when they're actually going to sleep. So say you're putting the kid to bed at 9, and that's what you want, the ideal bedtime, but if they're actually going to bed, they're not falling asleep until 11, you'd start the faded bedtime intervention by actually sending them to bed at 12. So you'd be keeping them up for an hour after they're currently falling asleep. The ideal wake time is determined based on the hours of sleep that they need for their age, and then that ideal bedtime that you picked. So if you pick the ideal bedtime at 9 o'clock and the kid needs 9 hours of sleep, then they have to get up at 6 a.m. Yeah, so then they'd be waking at 6 a.m. That's how you would calculate based on when you're gonna wake them up.
Say that one more time again.
Yeah, so if you're saying, I want my child to go to bed at 9 o'clock, and based on their age, they need 9 hours of sleep, that means their wake time would be 6 a.m. So you're not gonna let the child sleep past that wake time, even when you put them to bed at 12. Okay, and then based on you selecting the 9 p.m. bedtime, the number of hours they need for their age, we've said is 9, then you're waking them up at that 6 a.m. time. So they'd really only be getting 6 hours of sleep. So you're sort of creating a sleep debt, increasing the motivation to engage in sleeping, making them tired, basically.
And then what?
So then you wake them up at that 6 a.m. time, we're saying, and the following night, instead of putting them to bed at 12, you're going to put them to bed at 11:45. So you move slowly closer and closer to that ideal bedtime.